a special edition of Casa e Cucina. We're down here on Marconi Avenue, and shortly the president is going to be arriving down here. I'm sure you've seen it on the news and stuff, but this, by the time you see this, that day is all past. But we have a very special show for you today with music and just a good time. So, sono qui to Valentino e questa è Casa e Cucina. Sit back and enjoy a great Italian-American show.
Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce. Gente dalle anni, una bella voce, siamo una bella voce. Gente dalle anni, lavoriamo, mangiamo, beviamo, cantiamo, balliamo, festeggiamo insieme. Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce. Lavoriamo, mangiamo, beviamo, cadiamo, belliamo, festeggiamo insieme. Una bella voce, siamo una bella voce. Gente, alle anni.
As an Italian-American, to have the President of the United States come down and visit our neighborhood.
I think it's a great honor for us to have him visit us and that he chose our area to come to. I think that's one of the main things. I'll let my wife say something.
I don't have anything to say except I just think it's thrilling. We're all here, and everybody, whether, no matter how you feel about any politics, we're all here to see him, and I think it's great.
Very momentous day. The President of the United States is coming a block from my house. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. We're all proud that he's coming, and we're welcoming him.
Yeah, everybody pretty happy about it. Thought of the hill, coming here, see us. We're going to see him. That's it. That's all there is to it.
The president coming down to our neighborhood.
It's a good deal.
You lived here all your life.
That's right. It's a good deal, good thing for the neighborhood and for the people. People never seen something like this. I appreciate it. So it's good for everybody.
All your years on the hill, have you ever seen anything like this?
Not like this, no. I've seen years ago, you know, they went by, they never stopped that. You'd never get this close to them or nothing years ago. So it's a good thing.
How do you feel about the President of the United States coming down to our neighborhood?
I love it. It's nice to get a half a day off work.
Yeah, half a day off of work, huh?
Yeah, but I had to use a half a holiday. But
you're pretty good at bocce.
All right.
You're all right?
Yeah. I won't spot you no points, but I'll take your money.
Oh, you're pretty humble, Steve.
I try to be. We'll see tomorrow at Bella Bocce when a tournament's on.
Yeah, I heard about that. You think you're going to really crack down on these people, huh?
We got some good teams. We got some mediocre teams, but they all paid $100 a team. You never know what could happen. Look at the Blues and Red Wings.
Yeah, right. Okay, brother, thanks.
All right.
You bet.
I'm glad to see that the President of the United States coming here. It is once in a lifetime. Maybe I'll get the opportunity to shake his hand. I've never shook a president's hand before in my life. I think it'd be interesting. Be nice to, beautiful neighborhood we live in, to have the president come here. It really means a lot. It really means a lot for the neighborhood and what he thinks of
the Italian Americans.
Yeah, the Italian Americans,
right,
in this community here.
Okay, good. Thanks. Italian American and having the President of the United States come down here to then visit us down here on the hill.
I think it's a big honor. No, what can I say?
It's great.
I think it's exciting.
You think it's exciting?
Uh-huh.
And then you got here early, didn't you?
Uh-huh. So I could see him, maybe shake his hand.
Great. Good deal. She cuts my hair, folks.
Well, I hope they have the national press here to, you know, show a little bit of the hill. I think it's really an honor that they picked the Bocce Club. I wish they would let more people get in a little bit, but...
And the sign?
Oh, my sign. I made a cool sign. Bill is on the hill. And the Secret Service guy thought I was going to poke the president with it. So he made me leave it outside. So Brian McDonald is skateboarding around with my sign.
Okay,
so we're excited about him being here.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thanks a lot.
Okay.
What does it mean to you having the President of the United States come down to the and visit our beautiful Italian section of town known as the Hill?
Well, we're all proud of it. That's we further than our grandparents got. When we had all the men or the mayor come out here, we thought it was something. They did something great. And this is the biggest thing ever happened on the Hill. First president ever came to the Hill. So we're proud of it.
And I guess this man right here holds a very special kind of pride because he's one of the people that helped build the Bocce Club. It was a group effort.
That's
but
right.
You're the one that designed the place, basically.
Well, I had 40 men helping me. 43 employees.
43 employees.
43. They were free. No pay. No one got a pay.
It's a beautiful club, George. Did a great job.
No plans, no ideas, no nothing. We just went in and did it.
And to think that how many years later after you built this place has gone up?
Oh, we went in here with about 135 members. Now we got over 545.
545. But when you first started cleaning the place up and drawing up the plans, did you have any idea that the President of the United States might come by and visit?
No way. We didn't think the aldermen would come in there. We thought we were. The aldermen were too good to come in there, but now we even got the president there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I bet you the aldermen show up.
Oh, he'll be here today.
Yeah. Well, yeah, Bob or Jerry, he's a real guy,
real good member. He was a member of our club.
I guess Mayor Bosley will be here, too.
He's supposed to be here.
Senator Ashcroft.
They're all going to be in here
Richard
today.
Gephardt.
That's right.
So they'll all be here.
So
I wonder if they'll bless this place.
Oh, it's been blessed a couple of times by the local priest here. They all bless it.
Okay, George. Thanks a lot.
Okay, Keith.
Ciao, brother.
All right.
Oh,
hope you enjoyed that. We got something really special coming up, but I want you to take a look around here to all these folks. These are all from the press channel 2, 4, 5, 9, 11, 30, and from different agencies all over the world, except for the AP people. They're down there with the president. It's a very hot day, and this is what they have to do, is they have to stand out here for hours upon hours upon hours, dripping, soaking, sunstroke, heat stroke. But we had water. That's right, we had water. So anyway, sit back and enjoy this segment. It's great. It's what we've been waiting for.
Buongiorno. Welcome to the Hill. My name is Father Tom Santon, I'm the pastor of St. Ambrose Parish, and I'd like to invite you to go on a tour of the hill, getting a taste of our heritage and our history. Our tour begins today, fittingly enough, here in this beautiful church of St. Ambrose, the heart of our neighborhood, the heart of our faith life. We invite you now to sit back and relax as we share with you our heritage, our life.
While clinging to their ancestral Italian culture, the Hill community maintained a fierce patriotism for their newly adopted country. They were now Americans. Many fought in World War I, and many of their sons served, fought, and died in World War II. After World War II, new homes blossomed on the Hill in single-family brick homes. Many children and grandchildren of the Italian immigrants chose to remain and raise their families on the Hill and continued to thrive in culture, independence, and in faith. In 1972, a looming cloud threatened the unity of the Hill community. The federal highway was to run through the Hill, literally cutting off one segment of the community from the other. In 1972, Senator John Volpe of Massachusetts was approached by Father Salvatore Polizzi, the Hill community's priest and activist. Father Sal pleaded for an overpass to link the neighborhood divided by the highway, which was previously denied by the state. Volpe was extremely impressed because Father Sal and the Hill residents raised $50,000 toward the expense of the overpass. The state highway department was overruled, the overpass completed, and the neighborhood was reunited. Many families lived in shotgun frame houses of 3 to 4 rooms. Many were built with lumber salvaged from the World's Fair of 1904. Basements were rare. Friends, neighbors gathered together, helping to dig basements, lay sidewalks, build additions to homes, all while enjoying the camaraderie of one another. Several Italians, as a result of personal toil and sacrifice, succeeded in establishing their own private businesses on the Hill. In the entire United States, there is no community as unique as the Hill neighborhood. It continues to be a vital, vibrant part of the city of St. Louis. It can only be described as a mosaic, a composite of lives, young and old, rich with tradition, talent, dedication, and above all, sacrifice. Their paths have led them to a variety of professions near and far, and yet the Hill remains their home. Doctors, carpenters, educators, plumbers, restaurateurs, athletes, lawyers, designers, religious men and women, blacksmiths, politicians. The Hill has become many things to many people, but to those rooted in an inherited Italian tradition of a beautiful culture fashioned through love of friends and neighbors, music and dance, joys and sorrows, and an ever-deepening faith in our church and our God, The Hill is church bells ringing at 6 in the morning, the smell of bread baking at daybreak, women dressed in black fingering their beads on the way to church, boxcar houses with odors a gourmet would die for, soccer ball games at Barrow Park, and men playing bocce at Roses or John's, or Mota at Regina's. Corpus Christi processions on a hot June afternoon. Sons and daughters of the brickyards with songs on her lips. Toil and sweat and calloused hands. Warm homes and stout hearts. Education, the future of youth. The Hill is sacrifice.
We hope you've enjoyed this tour of our history in slides. As you can see, we have a rich heritage and we've gone through many stages of development. We hope you'll join us many times, but we can't promise you that things will look exactly the same each time you come, because you see, this is a living neighborhood. This is where we live, where we worship. We continue to change and grow, building on our great heritage, our culture. Please join us anytime.
Arthur Gajarsa is the
Vice Chairman of the National Italian American Foundation.
Vice Chairman,
yes,
of the National Italian American Foundation.
Yes.
Great sense of humor this guy's got. Listen, I wanted to tell the folks out there, we had Frank Stella on there before, and he told us a little bit about the National Italian American Foundation and trying to get people involved in what they do?
Well, the National Italian American Foundation was founded 20 years ago by a group of members of Congress and a Monsignor by the name of Gino Baroni. Their idea was to set up a networking operation for Italian Americans, not only in Washington, but throughout the country.
This award here, it's for maintaining a positive image of the Italian American. That's exactly what you do out there. All you beautiful people, that banquet that you had out in October that honored Giorgio Armani, Geraldine Ferrara. I want to make sure that the Honorable Frank Guarini gets this also because of all the work that he does through the National Italian American Foundation.
Absolutely.
Senator the Honorable Frank Guarini.
Thank you very much.
And my pal. I'm going to make sure, I'm going to put this in your hands. I wanted it to hand deliver, but he missed his flight out here. Fred Rotondaro.
Dr. Alfred Rotondaro, who's the executive director of the foundation.
I just put on there Fred because that's how I know him. He's just a beautiful, beautiful man.
He certainly is.
And there's, like I told Fred, Frank Stella, that we could, that there's, they don't make enough of these things for all the butchers, bakers, lawmakers, senators, policemen, firemen, in every field that you could possibly think of, there's an Italian American.
Who contributes very much to the fabric of the American community.
Right.
Art, thank you very much.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Art. Ciao.
Folks, here on the Hill, folks, with the president visiting our community. But I want to say one more thing before we sign off here, and that is to say congratulations to Mr. Arthur Gajarsa, who was just nominated by the president to the U.S. Court of Appeals, to the United States Court of Appeals out there in Washington, D.C. It's a lifetime position. I spoke with him the other day on the phone, and he's very excited, and he wanted to tell St. Louis that we have the Italian-American support in Washington. So, Mr. Arthur Gajarsa, congratulations from the St. Louis Italian community. And everybody else, ciao. Arrivederci.
Grazie, grazie a tutti. Io sono Tito Valentino e questa è Casa e Cucina. Everyone, thank you for tuning in today and thank you very much for watching. We're on every week. So until next time, ciao, arrivederci, ci vediamo, addio. Ciao, arrivederci, ci vediamo. Ci vediamo presto nel prossimo programma. Sì, 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 è vero. Addio a tutti. Ciao. Arrivederci. Ci vediamo. Addio. Il Signore te benedice.